4, 3, 2. All good things must come to an end. And this season has been fantastic, to say the least. And as we go into this final round, there are 5 people that are mathematically within a chance of winning the championship. We have Coulthard, who has a very good starting position for this race. He has sat in the championship lead by 2 points over Felipe Massa. And he starts 4th. The next person on the grid within a chance is Nico Rosberg. He starts 10th. He is 3 points behind Coulthard. Then on the grid, it's Michael Schumacher, who is 10 points behind. So he's come into this round in the same situation he did in real life, just with a different person trying to win the championship, and he starts 3 places back from where he did in real life due to the reverse grid, I think. Well, based on how I've put it, I think I've done it right. Yeah, I've done it right. I don't know why I'm doubting myself. Then it is Fisichella, who is also on 40 points, but he starts further back than Schumacher. And last but not least, second place man Felipe Massa, who lost the championship lead last round. So, I think Coulthard's going to do it, to be honest. I think he's going to do it. The only other person I could see winning this title is Rosberg. Even then, that is a very unlikely shout, because 4th place for Coulthard at the start, it's the only way you're going to beat that is if in real life you start behind him, which none of the other 4 did. So Coulthard within a very good shout here, as the lights are out for the final time of the 2006 season, and everyone scrambles off the line as they're going very different lines in to turn 1. As this, Albers, where did that come from? And Liuzzi gets into the slipstream of Coulthard. Could this be a terrible start for David Coulthard? Liuzzi has a look up the inside. Oh, Coulthard runs wide. Liuzzi's still on the inside. They go side by side. And Coulthard nearly lost 5th place. This has not been a good start at all for David Coulthard. And, oh wow, aggressively around the outside of Albers. But Albers defends the place for now. And no, he goes wide. And Coulthard, sorry, never mind. As there is Schumacher already into the points. So Schumacher's not giving up on this. There's Fisichella. He's in 12th, so he's had a very good start as well. Rosberg's had a poor start. So the only other person I said I could see winning this championship has had probably the worst start out of everyone, as Schumacher needed to get past Button there, but he hasn't done it, as Coulthard slipstreams Yamamoto down into turn 1. And Coulthard will surely go up the inside. Ooh, Yamamoto gives him a squeeze. Yamamoto has the inside line for turn 2, but no. Oh, that's Kubica.
Montoya was also involved in that scrape.
De La Rosa. Okay. There's Massa in 12th. There's Fisichella in 11th. As that is, who is that? That is Yamamoto out, which makes that easier for Coulthard. And some of the other drivers. As Coulthard runs wide there. Schumacher's dropped back from Button, as Button is having a go at Liuzzi, who needs to get past Albers if he wants to defend his position.
Down 6 places from his qualifying position.
as Montero trying to run away with things whilst he can. Montero didn't set a time in qualifying, which is why he started on pole position. There is Robert Dornbus, Scott Speed. Fisichella is in 10th place. And Rosberg, 15th. He is last out of everyone that could win this championship. So, this has not been a good start for Rosberg, as Sato expertly defends into turn 1. As Liuzzi does not repeat what Sato did. As Coulthard up the inside into turn 4. And David Coulthard is through up into 2nd place. He really wants this championship. And all that stands between him and the and a race win, which would completely secure the championship, is Thiago Montero. I don't fancy the chances of everyone else. However, I said that at the start, and Schumacher is up in... Well, is he up? No, he's stayed the same in 7th place. Fisichella is up into 9th. Massa in 10th place. So the others are charging through the field whilst they can. But they're going to have to do it and catch up to Coulthard before he gets past Montero. Now, we do have a lot of laps here. So that is going to play into the hands of the other drivers, as Schumacher is up into 6th place as Fisichella slipstreams Dornbus down the main straight as he's going to look around the outside as he enters turn 1. Schumacher had a look at going 3 wide with Albers and Button as Button is through into 4th place. Schumacher is now the man looking to get past Christian Albers, and this should be an easy move, you'd think, for the Ferrari. Coulthard is 2nd. Pulls out the slipstream, looks to go up the inside, he's through before the braking zone. And Fisichella is looking to get past Dornbus. They go side by side through turn 4. Dornbus runs wide. And they go side by side through turn 5. Felipe Massa is in there as well. And Dornbus defends the place for now, helping his teammate whilst he can. As Coulthard gets very close to the back of Thiago Montero. That would not have been good to have screwed that up. Gone into the back of Montero and lost a front wing, because that would have meant he would have had to pit, which would have put Schumacher into the lead out of those that can win the championship. But Schumacher and Fisichella both have to win the race. They have to win the race, and for Coulthard not to score any points to win this championship. I don't think that's going to happen. And Massa doesn't seem to be doing enough to win this title. Neither does Rosberg, who's down in 16th now. Rosberg is dropping back. And the only one that can take this championship without getting the race victory and Coulthard not scoring points is Massa. But Massa, 10th place, not doing the greatest. He's the one getting past Dornbus now. Coulthard is 2nd. Michael Schumacher 3rd. Oh, Schumacher up to 3rd as Coulthard moves up into 1st place. As Fisichella is the man in 6th place now, and he's going to be looking to get past Button and Sato as quickly as he can. As Thiago Montero looks to try. He's trying to keep on to Coulthard. It's not going to be working. It's not working. Massa down to 11th now as De La Rosa gets past. Massa is just watching his championship slip away. As Schumacher will certainly be doing all he can to try and win the race and the championship. Of course, his final season, at least until 2010. Definitely putting the pressure on. That last lap time was a 1.2. As he tries to squeeze up the inside of Thiago Montero, it doesn't quite work. And Montero is the man that stands between him and David Coulthard. And Schumacher, very good exit out of turn 3. He's already through before the braking zone. And we look back as Fisichella looks to get past Takuma Sato on the run down into turn 4. And he's through before the braking zone as well. What about Felipe Massa as he battles with De La Rosa and Christian Albers, and Massa still last out of that battle. This is not good for Felipe Massa. And we could be witnessing a championship to David Coulthard. as Schumacher absolutely steps on it as he tries to close in to David Coulthard, but it's not going to be enough to win the race. Granted, he does have to win this race, but Coulthard can't score points if Schumacher's going to win the championship. And I think Coulthard will be scoring points this race unless he retires for whatever reason.
Putting the pressure on. That last lap time was a 1:14.25. He's extended his lead over Montero. The gap has extended to 2.6 seconds.
Wow, puts 2.6 seconds in a very short amount of time, about a lap.
Michael Schumacher is in second. He's up from third. Third is Montero. Fourth is Fisichella. That's a gain of two places. Button is fifth. Sixth is Sartre. He slipped down from fourth. In seventh place is Liuzzi. And Christian Klien is in eighth.
So Schumacher closing in on David Coulthard. But as I said before, it won't be enough to take the race victory. He would lose the championship by 8 points to David Coulthard. And I think based on count back, Schumacher would finish third in the championship if he won. No, if he won this race, he'd finish second. If he came second, he'd finish third in the championship, because Massa on count back would beat him.
Definitely putting the pressure on. That last lap time was a 1:14, dead on. He's pulled away from Montero by some distance.
Good exit from Schumacher as he's going to look to go up the inside of David Coulthard into turn four. Can Coulthard defend for now? Yes, he can. What about Fisichella with Montero? As Fisichella is up the inside into the braking zone. A little bit of contact between the two. Fisichella forces Montero out wide. And here's the man into third place. So three of the guys that can win the championship are sat on the podium. As Schumacher gets right onto the back of David Coulthard. And he's looking whatever way he can to take this race victory. And he's going to need help from Fisichella to win the championship. He's going to need Fisichella to catch up to them and get past Coulthard. And maybe even knock him out, to be honest. Because I think that's the only way Coulthard might retire. We haven't seen a lot of Ferrari engine failures. We haven't seen too many. Renault have been a bit less reliable than Ferrari. And that could cost Ferrari, interestingly enough. Schumacher looking down the outside for now into turn one. Looks to the inside as they approach the braking zone. But he can't get it up the inside. But he is a lot closer to Coulthard this time around as they go through turn two. And they round the fast turn three.
Last lap time was a 1:14.76. Slower than that is Montero. He's been posting laps around the mid-1:17s.
So Montero is about 3 seconds a lap slower than Schumacher and Fisichella.
Michael Schumacher is in second. Fisichella third. He's up from fourth. Montero is fourth. Button is fifth. Liuzzi sixth. Montoya is seventh. That's a gain of two places. And Sato is in eighth.
Schumacher is getting so close to David Coulthard, but he can't find a way through yet. Where is Felipe Massa in all this? He's still down in 10th place. He's still behind Sato. And yet De La Rosa is up in 7th place, battling with Liuzzi. And Schumacher is very close to David Coulthard on the run down into turn 1. Down the outside will not work as he looks to get the inside line into turn 1. They're very close. They nearly touch. Coulthard runs a little bit wide. Schumacher runs wide through turn 2 as they almost go side by side. And Schumacher is very much in the slipstream of Coulthard as they exit down on the run into turn 4. Schumacher looking to go up the inside. But no, Coulthard defends the place for now. Coulthard is doing everything he needs to do to win this championship. Schumacher is doing everything he can to try to take it off him. And so is Fisichella. But the two of them alone is not enough to take this championship off of David Coulthard. They need Coulthard not to finish in the points. And there's not enough fast cars behind that can catch up in time and get past in time. So they need the Coulthard to retire. I think this is Coulthard's championship.
Oh! Oh! No way! No way! No way! Coulthard is out! And with first and second Fisichella and Schumacher, Coulthard is not going to win this championship unless both of them retire.
Michael Schumacher leads. That's a gain of one place.
No way! No way!
Button is third. Montero is fourth.
Massa is now into the points.
He was in the lead earlier.
So, as it stands,
And Christian Klien is in eighth.
Schumacher is first on countback with 50 points. Then it's David Coulthard, Felipe Massa in third, Giancarlo Fisichella fourth, and Nico Rosberg in fifth, all separated by 3 points. My throat is dead. My throat is just dead now. Massa needs to get past Donbus and Liuzzi. If he gets past Donbus, Massa.
Fisichella is really turning up the heat here. His previous lap time was 1:13.5.
If he gets past Donbus, I think Massa takes lead on countback.
The gap is now out to just under 2 seconds.
Is that between Button or between Schumacher? It might be between Schumacher. Fisichella might be closing in. Oh, please tell me he is. Please tell me he is. Fisichella is not going to nab this at the final round. He's not going to do it, is he? As Massa... I don't think it's going to be enough. It's not going to be enough for Fisichella or Schumacher. Especially as it's only Liuzzi. I think he's got the lead on countback. I think he does. Lead on countback, and the only thing that stands between him and winning on points is Liuzzi.
So he'd better make his move soon. It looks like Schumacher may be passed soon. The gap now stands at 1.8 seconds. That's a good end to the lap for Fisichella. The gap has been cut to 1.2 seconds.
1.2 seconds between Schumacher and Fisichella.
He's reduced the gap by another tenth of a second.
1.1 as they go into sector 2. But I don't think it's going to be enough for either of these two to get the race victory. Because I think Felipe Massa, despite the poor start, is going to just edge it out. Oh wow, Massa really involved in a battle now. He's got Montero and Liuzzi ahead of him. He's got Barrichello behind us. Barrichello goes up the inside! Barrichello has taken it. Schumacher's back into the lead of the championship.
And he's doing just that. The gap is extended to 1.3 seconds.
Okay. Oh, Massa. Back up the inside of Barrichello.
He's starting to push on now. He's reduced the gap to the car in front by half a second with some awesome driving.
Yes, defensive in to the final corner though. But he will get in the slipstream of Thiago Montero, and that should be an easy move for Felipe Massa. You'd think so anyway. And that was Michael completely wrap up the championship in Massa's favour.
The gap is now 9/10 of a second.
He's going to have to watch out for Barrichello and Donbus, I think, as they go three wide almost into turn one, and Massa and Barrichello go side by side through turn three. Massa gets the edge over Rubens Barrichello, and no matter how much Fisichella tries, he just can't get close enough to take the race victory off Schumacher. but it's just Montero that stands between Massa and a confirmed championship. As old Massa aggressively tries to get up the inside, as I'm starting to fumble my words, and Massa has a look around the outside on the exit of the hairpin. That's not working. Getting up the inside, he tries to, as Schumacher has started the final lap of the Grand Prix.
Michael Schumacher finishes the lap.
And right now, he's extended the gap. He needs his former teammate Rubens Barrichello to be his best friend and get back past Felipe Massa.
Upper place in the finishing positions. It looks like this race is still on. Michael Schumacher is building up.
The championship is still certainly completely undecided right now as Barrichello gets close to Massa again into turn one. But Massa is up the inside of Thiago Montero. And that could be it. Massa up into sixth place. And he is now on 51 points. A point ahead of his teammate Schumacher. And 3 points ahead of Giancarlo Fisichella.
Michael Schumacher piles on the pressure.
Schumacher rounds round the final corner and is going to go down the main straight and will come across the line to take the race victory. He's done all he can. He's beaten Fisichella, but what will happen here? No, he's got too much of a gap. Montero is not quick enough, and Barrichello and Dornbus have not been able to get through, which means, unless something miraculous happens for Schumacher and Fisichella, Massa will come round the final corner and he's going to exit out onto the banking. He'll go down the straight now and he comes across the line to take the championship win at his first season in Ferrari at his home Grand Prix. My throat has completely died. But Felipe Massa, wow, just wow.
Fascinating season with all manner of twists and turns to the story. It's been a wonderful journey for me and a real privilege to cover this season for you.
With all
the rules and regulations, it's been challenging at times, but I think you'll agree what we're seeing here is a firm indication that the
Massa
good times are back for Formula One.
He's done it. He's done it.
For sticking with us, and goodbye from all of us here at São Paulo, Brazil. We'll be back next year in the spring for another
season. Oh my days.
Of Formula One racing. Goodbye, and as always, take care.
He's taken it from his teammate by a point, and in the end, Fisichella lost out to the race win by a second and a half. As Rosberg finishes down in 13th, he finishes 5th place, maybe? Possibly. Well, I'll have to see in terms of the others that couldn't mathematically win the championship. But let's move on to the final standings of the championship. So taking a look at the final standings, and Felipe Massa, a point has done it. 51 points, there's barely anything. They were getting like hundreds of points at this time. And now they're getting, I mean, how many did Rosberg get? How many did Hamilton get in 2015? I mean, 51 points, that's going back to like, before the top 8 got points, like top 6 sort of era, but like before you got 10 points when you got like 9 points for the race victory. Schumacher 2nd, Coulthard 3rd, so get your tinfoil hats on, guys. I mean, one of the few Ferrari engine failures throughout the season, and it just so happens to be Coulthard costing him the championship. And it also means that Ferrari get a 1-2 in the drivers and exceed 100 points in the constructors. Get your tinfoil hats on, guys! Fisichella 4th, Button 5th, Rosberg in 6th, Barrichello 7th, Trulli 8th. Liuzzi didn't have a bad end to the season. Ninth place for him. Sato somehow top 10. That is impressive driving from Takuma Sato. How was he finished in the top 10 in the worst car on the grid? Okay. I mean, in reality, I was expecting them to get, at max, if they got lucky, 20 points. And Sato's ended with 35. He's beaten Ralf Schumacher, he's beaten Scott Speed, he's beaten Kimi Raikkonen, he's beaten Fernando Alonso. Okay, Montoya's down in 24th with 9 points. Dornbus, I feel a bit sorry for him, he got a little bit unlucky. He apparently, according to this, hasn't scored any points, which I believe is actually true. He didn't finish in the points in China. He was set for a podium in Japan. You gotta feel sorry for him. He was set for a podium and then his engine fails. That's also something to get your tinfoil hats on about. Ferrari have barely any engine failures throughout the season, and Red Bull have 2 in the final 2 rounds. Powered by, get your tinfoil hats on, guys. Yeah, as I said, looking at the constructors, Ferrari, they did exceed 100 points. 101 points. Not gonna make that reference. Not gonna make it. 101 points for Ferrari. Honda finishing second on 85. Super Guri. Okay. 77 points for Super Guri. Okay, sure. 70 points for Williams and Toyota, but Williams, Nico Rosberg, getting them the 4th place over Toyota Racing. Red Bull comes home in 6th, just 5 points ahead of Toro Rosso. Despite the fact that Coulthard is on 50, which is the top in Red Bull, and the top in Toro Rosso is Liuzzi on 35. There's a 15 point gap between the two best drivers in the teams, and they finish 5 points between them. Sure. Renault. They have a driver battling for the championship, and they're down in 8th in the constructors. That is what this reverse grid series can do. That's just absolutely incredible. The fact that Renault have finished in 8th, because there's been no changes in the constructors standings from the last round. So Red Bull, Renault down in 8th, and they have Fisichella battling for the championship. Sure, that's how it works. McLaren there, 9th, and Red Bull. Why do I keep saying Red Bull? BMW Sauber and Midlands both. I mean, it is Spyker Midlands. I said I was going to change it on the thing. I haven't got around to changing it. And we finished the season now, and it's still not changed. So, yeah, I'm good at this. Yeah, BMW Sauber and Midlands, they've both finished 20 points behind McLaren. They have done horrendously. I mean, BMW Sauber has a decent car. I think they finished 5th in real life. So, what? How? I don't know how they've done so terribly. I mean, I think, yeah, Villeneuve is still the top driver out of the 3 that have driven for BMW Sauber this season. Because Heidfeld was driving for them, Villeneuve was driving for them, and then Villeneuve left and Kubica took his place. And yet Villeneuve is still the best out of the 3. Good. Okay. This season has been incredible. Let's be honest. I mean, 4 points separates the top 6 in the drivers. Sure, the constructors wasn't overly tight in terms of the lead, but the drivers has been incredibly contested. There's, what, five different teams there in the drivers' standings? You've got two Ferrari, one Red Bull, one Renault, one Honda, and one Williams. So, yeah, this... Wow. I remember Pierre Luton Rule Series. Alonso won the title earlier than he did in the actual 2006 season. It made it worse for the smaller teams, in a sense. I mean, they got more points than they did in real life. They were able to score points, but in terms of actually who won the championship, it was easier for him in the reverse grid format. But in this one, Alonso finished down in 21st. He hasn't even broken into the top 20. Like 12 points for Alonso in this season, which is... How many did he score in real life? I'm going to have to check this. I know this outro is taking forever, but it's the final. It's the final round. I'm allowed this one. I mean, I know I've taken ages, pretty much all of them, as I've on the mic. But, yeah. It's the final round. I'm allowed this. Yeah, so we scroll down to 2006. Fernando Alonso, in the real-life season, won on 134 points. In this reverse grid series, he's finished 122 points lower than he did in real life. That's a lot, to be honest. That is a lot. But anyway, enough rambling from me. The next video, I've no idea what it's going to be, to be honest. I'm thinking about doing a Sims series as well, because why not, and have the free will and maximum, and shout at them when they make mistakes and things like that. So there's that. That's an idea. But anyway, I'll figure out what video is next at some point, eventually. I probably should go do that now, to be honest. But this has been one hell of a season. And if for whatever reason you did enjoy me shouting into a mic at a, what, 11-year-old game now? 10, 11-year-old game? And basing it off like a 10, 11-year-old F1 season. I'm so up to date on this channel. All the trending topics are on this channel. But yeah, if for whatever reason you like this series, this video, yeah, if you go ahead and click that like button. I need them views. And gotta make that YouTube money, you know. God, I've made like 10 pence throughout this channel's entire lifetime, so I do this for fun. If you like it, sure, you can click like if you want. I mean, I'm not exactly making you do anything, but it would be much appreciated if you did click like, and if you're new around here, it would be much appreciated if you did hit that subscribe button, and I might actually be consistent again, so. Whatever, I've been Speeding Viper. This has been one hell of a season, and I'll join you next time.